I'm Lou Dauber, and today we're going to talk about Kafka and financial services. I'm going to explain how real-time streams are shaping three ongoing initiatives shared by many financial services organizations. Those projects drive growth, manage regulation, and mitigate risk. In the past, big data dominated the discussion about how companies could obtain greater value from their data. It was based on a simple premise. The more data I can store in a single location and analyze, the deeper and more valuable the insights I could obtain. However, it ignored another value principle of data, the time value. There is value in data when it's young. The faster you can get a piece of data and respond to it, the more valuable it is. By comparison, streaming data takes the idea of low latency data at scale and makes it possible to use a platform to connect all the applications and systems in your company. It acts, in effect, as a digital nervous system, both distributing the data out to every corner of your organization and at the same time centralizing that data and allowing it to be acted on quickly. Streaming data will be fueling our economy because it allows you to build and operationalize intelligence at scale in real time, often delivering value in a matter of weeks. Yet, few organizations possess the ability to capitalize on streaming data because it's so new. In the Kafka survey that Confluent ran in the summer, 80% of organizations said that finding qualified Kafka engineers is hard or really hard. But those that can build smarter, faster, and more efficient businesses. In financial services, streaming data is redefining competition in three important ways. First, customers now value their time too much to spend it on traditional banking. Products have become commoditized and are now differentiated through the experience alone. Some financial services companies now describe themselves as an IT organization that happens to operate in the banking industry. With retail banking, the ability to anticipate and meet the needs of consumers on the go is critical to customer retention. Second, as data sources increase and threats increase, regulatory bodies are working hard to protect consumers and investors. They do that by introducing new regulations at a rate of 200 new regulations every single day. The total in 2015 was over 50,000 alerts issued. Building a system that allows you to systematically adjust to meet these requirements using features like Schema Registry and Confluent Platform can significantly improve operations and even be a competitive advantage. Third, the teams that manage risk and asset exposure face ever faster moving competition. They can't wait until the end of the day anymore to learn what asset exposures exist. They now have access to an increasing volume of data sources to improve the speed and responsiveness of their decision making. This causes contention between back office systems and the rapid ingest of data from external sources. In the context of these ongoing initiatives, the Confluent platform provides a way to centralize all of your data and operationalize its distribution across your organization, making every event or message available to many systems at very low latency. Now, you can publish and subscribe to streams of data like a messaging system, process streams of data efficiently and in real time, and store data safely in a distributed replicated cluster. Imagine the possibilities. Let's dig into some examples of how companies are using real-time streams to address these initiatives. This block diagram shows a generic version of a customer 360 platform. On the left, the data sources where customer signals are first captured, places like your mobile app, the ATM machine, a call center, your website, or others. These feed into your core systems, perhaps using Kafka as a data pipeline. Your core systems might be things like a database of your customer accounts, or a trading platform where you're collecting a continuous stream of asset prices. For the core systems and the event source systems, you would feed these into what we call topics in Kafka. Asset prices might be a topic, or customer actions might be a topic. These pipelines now create a single source of truth that can be consumed by many other systems. You might want to deposit the data in real time into a data warehouse or a data lake. Kafka provides a way to do that without running a daily batch process. Now your data warehouse is up to the minute and up to date. It all comes from the same source, so all the systems agree on what happened and when. This next block diagram shows a streaming platform applied to a customer experience, but taking to a broad level, where the events are driving the business logic of the entire bank. On the left side, you can see producers pushing data to a raw event bus. These are then processed by a relevance engine to determine only events that the bank wants to make decisions from. These are fed to a new pipeline called business relevant events, which can then feed a global pipeline and regional pipelines for various purposes. These streams can then be deposited to different repositories for compliance or audits. And this business relevant events bus can also be used to educate a machine learning model or be used to drive business logic that feeds customer communications. Another way to use Kafka is as a real-time shock absorber for financial systems. For instance, in a trading desk environment, you can use it as a buffer between real-time execution and downstream systems that are still highly batch-oriented. Confluent and Kafka absorb bursts, persist, and queue messages for fan-out, so slow consumers don't impact trading systems or other consumers. It significantly improves performance of downstream systems, and the replayability of the distributed log at the heart of Kafka improves high availability and monitoring capabilities. What is this Confluent platform? It is founded on Apache Kafka, then adds needed layers of tools and software that improve developer productivity, observability, and operational excellence. The Apache Kafka and Confluent open source portions are completely open source under the Apache 2.0 license. Confluent Enterprise adds the operational features that allow your teams to run Kafka and the Confluent platform smoothly. Let's take a quick look at some of the companies who are publicly using Kafka or Confluent platform to implement various systems in this space. There are many more, but these are the folks that you can contact or read about their Kafka deployments in their engineering blogs. The last two slides show you quotes from real customers. Rabobank says, "We have effectively elevated all customer expectations by sending alerts with a latency of seconds instead of minutes or hours." Goldman Sachs says, "With an up-to-the-moment view of all activity, we can better meet regulatory constraints, combat fraud, and remain competitive in a rapidly changing landscape." This is our management team. Confluent was founded in 2014 and has been growing rapidly since. We were founded by the creators of Apache Kafka at LinkedIn and are funded by some of the most successful venture firms, including Benchmark and Sequoia. More than 75% of the code in Kafka was written by employees of Confluent. Thank you for listening. I hope this talk has been helpful.